every day feels exactly the same. I'm having the worst nightmares till morning. Another sleepless day begins.
It's a beautiful day, isn't it?
There is no place to sit here.
Excuse me. I think you wanted to sit alone because when you saw me, I had the feeling that you were a bit hesitant. Please stay. I'll leave.
You don't bother me. On the contrary, I'm glad that I'm not alone once in a while. I haven't said a word to anyone for 10 days. This situation is so hard. It's so depressing to hold it all inside of me. I would like to ask you something. Actually, to tell you something. I know how absurd it is to tell this to the first person I've just met, but I'm in such a state that I definitely need to talk to someone, or I will be ruined.
You should not torture yourself with such suspicions. You can tell me everything.
I'm a doctor. This is the climax of my story. In this profession, we often encounter different cases, very serious cases. Imagine a doctor in a town, or a doctor in a countryside. It is not going to work this way. I must tell you everything from the very beginning, explicitly. Otherwise, you will not understand.
Madam, a lady.
A lady has arrived.
A lady? In this town?
Good day, Doctor. Forgive me for popping in unannounced, but we were driving by the station and we thought we should drop by.
Let's continue this conversation in my room.
I've heard a lot of things about you. The way you treated the deputy governor was unbelievable. His leg is almost as perfect as it used to be. He can keep on playing golf where he left off. If you agree to come with us, we are more than ready to send our grumpy surgeon and the other doctors away. All aside, Why don't we see you around? You live like a hermit. I like it here. There are such nice books. I want to read them all.
May I treat you a cup of tea?
No, thanks. We don't have much time. It was just a short trip. Ah, I see you study French as well. You have many talents. It is indeed an amazing thing to know this many languages. The deputy governor adores you, you know. He says he'd only go under your knife. Surgeons where I come from do nothing but play bridge. And you know, I thought I should get examined by you as I happened to be passing by.
I'd be honored to be of service to you whenever you'd like.
Oh, it's nothing serious, just womanly issues. Vertigo, passing out, that sort of thing. Just as the car was taking a turn, I suddenly collapsed. I thought I'd die. It was only after my servant brought me some water that I regained consciousness. Maybe the driver had been driving too fast. Right, doctor?
I can't just diagnose it as such. How often do you experience passing out?
No. In fact, yes. I've had those especially recently. Passing out and nausea. There isn't anything to worry about, is there, doctor? I guess it's a seasonal, temporary condition.
First, I need to examine you. Can I check your body temperature?
I don't have fever. I'm sure that I don't. I've been checking my body temperature regularly since I started passing out. My stomach is healthy, too.
I'm sorry, but can I ask you a few straightforward questions?
Of course. You're the doctor, anyway.
Do you have children?
Yes, I have a son.
Well, did you have similar experiences in those days?
I did.
Forgive me for asking this question, but could it be that you're experiencing a similar condition?
Could be. But what's making me nervous is not that, doctor. I was in a better state when I was pregnant with my son. I'm not as well anymore. I suffer from cardiac disease.
Ah, these cardiac diseases. I want to check it right away.
I do have issues regarding my heart, doctor, and I'd like you to believe me. I don't want to waste any more time being examined. I think that you can trust me. At least, I've already shown you my trust in you.
If you want me to trust you, you have to be clear. I'm the doctor here. Stop beating around the bush.
Do you understand what I'm asking of you, doctor?
I guess I know. You want to get rid of what's been ailing you. You want me to save you from these passing out sessions and nausea by destroying its source. Is that right?
That's right.
Do you also know that experiments like these can be dangerous for both sides?
I do.
You also know that it's forbidden for me to do such a thing.
I do know that it's not forbidden, and even recommended under certain circumstances.
But that requires a medical symptom.
Then you'll identify that symptom. You're the doctor.
Can I ask you why you specifically chose to come to me?
Because of the fact that you live far away. That you don't know me. That you're a good doctor. Because you probably won't be staying here for very long. Especially if you're going to be heading back home with a hefty amount of money.
And you'd give that hefty amount of money to me, is that right? Do you know that I lose my pension because of this?
I'll make up for your loss.
I want you to be clearer. What's the amount you do have in mind?
I'll write you a check of £12,000 that can be cashed out in Europe.
£12,000? There's no way I can do that for that amount.
How much do you want?
Let's be honest with each other. No amount of money will get you what you want.
So you're saying you don't want to do this?
No, I don't. Not for money, at least.
What else could you possibly want?
I'm not just a doctor. I don't just spend my hours examining patients. I have my own private life, apart from all that. And maybe you've happened to come just in time for that.
No, I will never do that. I'd rather die. don't you ever try and come after me, or follow me, or else you'll be sorry for it.
Do you have a request, Doctor?
She talked about the train station. I guess I should go there.
What's up?
What's up?
I expressed myself poorly. As a doctor, I should have helped. I must catch up and apologize.
Hey, howdy. Don't wander around here.
Go back to your country.
Hello, Doctor. I was hoping to visit you tomorrow, too. Is there a problem?
Hey, howdy.
It's good to see you, Doctor.
Hurry up, the train's about to leave.
I liked her, but she managed to flee the town just like all other times. But running away won't save her. Nothing remains a secret here. It's a small town. Now I know that you're the wife of a big businessman, a wealthy English of a noble origin.
Riverside 81 Super Express has departed from Platform 2. The next service is 2 hours later. Have a good trip.
Where do you think you're going, asshole? Where do you think you're going, asshole? Where do you think you're going, asshole? Show yourself, coward. Where's your god now, weakling?
Go away, you damn piece of shit.
evening news resumes. Recent news about the death of a citizen upset the town. This unfortunate event took place in the evening. A person thought to have symptoms of the Amok disease stabbed a young woman to death. The victim's identity is not yet known. Later, the attacker himself committed suicide using the same knife. We'll be back after a short break.
Careful!
Be careful!
Containers have blocked the road. I guess I need to move them out of the way to pass. Letters appear to have been hidden between the numbers. Letters appear to have been hidden between the numbers. letters appear to have been hidden between the numbers. Letters appear to have been hidden between the numbers. Letters appear to have been hidden between the numbers.
Thank you.